Let me tell you something. You can dream all you want. Kid came to me the other day. He's about 24 years old. He wants to be an animator. Everybody dogging him out. He was like, E.T., maybe my dreams are too big. I said, no such thing. Ain't nothing wrong with your dreams. Your strategy is off, though. Your dreams are great. Keep your big dreams. The people who dog you out is probably people with small dreams. Don't worry about them. You're going to run across a lot of them. You're going to run across a lot of average people who don't think big. Don't let that disturb you. Don't let that distract you. You keep your goals. But I need to know the steps. What steps are you going to take to make that happen? What you going to do on Monday? I don't see that. What you going to do on Tuesday? Like, you just showing me your dream. I don't see what you doing on Wednesday. What time you getting up on Saturday? What you doing on the weekend when everybody else chilling? Show me your plan. Don't just show me your dreams. So if we going to win 58, we're going to have some steps to go with that. All doable. I walked in here, bro. Some of y'all are too tall to walk in the door. You got what it, you got the athleticism. Now we need the plan. You got to be intentional and deliberate. I don't wear Reebok. Ain't nothing wrong with Reebok. I just don't wear them. I ain't associate. I don't know nobody other than the pumps. You know what I'm saying? And the dump. I don't really know a lot of people that wore. I know Nike. I wear Muhammad Ali for a reason. I wear J's for a reason. I ain't trying to be fashionable. Muhammad Ali was the best to do it. And I saw him as a kid. I was born in the 70s. I saw him go to work. I watched MJ do his thing. I don't wear it because I'm fashionable. I wear it because I want to be associated. I want to be around greatness. I know what Nike represent. Serena with him. Kobe was with him. Jordan was with him. You got to be intentional and deliberate. Now, here's what I mean when I say 120. So I had a guy the other day, you know, I was on the phone with a guy and he said he was a Laker fan from back in the day. I was like, oh, what era? He was like, you know, Kobe, Gasol. I was like, all right, do me a favor. You really a Laker fan? He's like, yeah. I was like, name everybody that played on the squad that year. He couldn't name them. I said, bro, I thought you said you was a Laker fan. Like, I can't name him. I ain't no Laker fan. I'm from Detroit. I'm a Piston fan. I can't name him. I can name Isaiah Dumars. I can name them all. John Sally. I can name him Rodman. I can name him Lambeer. I can name him Buddha, Microwave. I can name him. Name him. He couldn't name him. I said, who can you name? He said, I can name Kobe, Gasol, and Odom. I was like, who was the best out of all of them? They said Kobe. I said, absolutely. 120. The reason why you can't name the other jokers, not because they didn't play on the team and not because they weren't professional, but they weren't given 120. So you don't remember who they were. And you went to a whole bunch of the games. They were professional, but they weren't 120. You'll never forget Kobe. He was 120. Not perfect, but 120. He gave everything he had. Mike was 120. Gave everything he had. 120. Michael Phelps, 120. Serena, 120. I'm saying to you, that since you have to give an effort anyway, it might as well be 120. Why? Because when you do 120, you ain't never got to work again. You can name some dudes in the league that went 120, they got jobs now. Kobe never had to work again. Mike never had to work again. Why? Because they were dying. Serena will never work again. Michael Phelps will never work again. He didn't just swim. He was a swimmer. Serena was the best that ever do it. I'm telling you, here's what I know it's going to take to get to 58. It's going to take your best game every night. How do you get your best game? I don't have the slightest idea. I get my best game by getting up at 3 o'clock in the morning. People say to me all the time, you get up at 3 o'clock in the morning, have you lost your mind? I say, have you lost yours? I live in America. You mean to tell me I can get up at 3 o'clock in the morning and be a multimillionaire? You mean to tell me I can get up at 3 o'clock in the morning, I can go get a master's and a PhD, I can be a New York Times bestseller? You mean to tell me I can take care of my family by getting up at 3 o'clock in the morning and I can take a nap whenever I want to? I'll do whatever it takes. I've been getting up at 3 o'clock in the morning since I was about 1920. First hour I dedicate to God. Next hour, my accountability crew. Next hour, a little walking. I try not to do too much exercise. You feel me? I'll be seeing people, I'm like, you about to die. You know what I'm saying? You're doing too much. I'm just going to walk. You know what I'm saying? Because I see the old ladies just walking in the mall. They old. Hey, I don't see them lifting no weights and doing no burpees and nothing like that. They just walking for an hour. I'm like, that's what I like that. That's what I'm going to do. So I'm just being real. If you live in a third world country, I don't care what time you get up. I don't care what time you go to bed. You in a third world country. You can't be an NBA star. You can't be an NFL star. You guys have an opportunity of a lifetime, and it's a short window. I'm telling you, it's a short window. You're not going to be doing this at 47 years old, 58 years old, 62. So if you got 10 years, why not give 120? Because if you give 120, man, it feel good, bro. I get 120, I'm walking through the, I'm talking about airport, I'm going out to eat, cats like, I love it too, because you know, I grew up in the African-American community, so you know, bros be coming up to me like, what up, ET? Like, bro, I don't be taking pictures with grown men, but. I'm like, bro, you ain't got, it's all good. You ain't gonna lose your masculinity, bro. E, you changed my life, bro. You got me ironing my wife's clothes. You helped my mom get through chemotherapy. Bruh, it feel good giving 120 and know when I die that my name will live forever. My videos will live forever. It feels good knowing that I own my own dynasty and I run my own life because I gave 120. And was it difficult? Absolutely it was. Did I want to chill out while other people was on the plane playing video games and watching movies? I wanted to watch it too, but I was working on my dissertation. It was worth it. That dissertation was worth it. The master's was worth it. The GED was worth it. The writing the book. I'm asking you to do me a favor. I'm asking you, if you're going to get to 58, you can't give me 70-30. You can't give me 60-40. You can't give me 75-25. You can't give me 80-20. You're going against some other dudes in this league who have won and they tasted success and they don't want to give it up. They tasted it, y'all. They felt what it felt like to be on the bus. I know what it's like to be on the bus. I know what it feels like, guys. There are people who live that lifestyle and they not trying to give it up. You got to take it from them. Ain't nobody trying to give it up. Kids come here all the time. E.T., I'm going to take your spot. How? I want you to take it, but I'm not giving it to you. I want you to be the next great speaker. I do. If you had 100 of me in the school system, 100 of me in the prisons, it wouldn't be enough for all the crime and what our kids are going through. It wouldn't be enough, but I'm not about to give it to you. You got to come take it.